Hello, world. Mr. Resistor here, continuing our alpha journey. And, well, big news. Expansion's live. Kind of curious about the, aligning with other, with pirate factions. Could be interesting. Have to check out, well, enhancements to corporation projects and stuff. Oh, and air opportunities. We'll take a look at that. New ships, I don't think I'll be able to fly. I'm wondering. Maybe I'll check out the documentation. Not on air, but I'm wondering if it's possible to create a pirate character. That might be something worth looking at in the future on this channel. If so, I'd probably start a new character and at least go through the initial stuff. I don't know, sort of like the first, whatever, 20 or so, episodes of this channel, so, yeah, maybe we'll look at that, that would be cool, or maybe I'll, try and align with one of these guys. I don't remember off the top of my head. I guess I'd want to go with the one that fights against Amar, and I don't remember off the top of my head which one it is. So, or I guess I could pick the, I remember reading somewhere that they're against two Empire factions, right? So, like, oh, wait, do we have, maybe we shall take a look at this. Pirate insurgencies, right. Do. Okay, got a new ship caster. Oh, there's a battle cruiser. From each. So Titan. And destroyers. So there will be pirate forward operating bases, 48-hour setup time. Interesting. Vanguard. Come online in December. Definitely be trying that. I don't know if I'll be able to provide video. I certainly don't want to break any NDAs or anything. I did sign up, and they had one test that I was invited to, but I wasn't able to join because it was early in the morning on a weekday. So okay. Corporation projects with ISK payouts. Nice. That's cool. Seven new project types: remote armor repair, remote boost shields, destroy capsule ship, scan signature. Interesting. Project cloning. Alright, cool. Whoever took this screenshot has a nice purple theme. That's pretty nice. Oh, alphas get access to pre-made UI themes. Maybe I should switch to purple. Alright. Oh. And free Omega time. It's today. 14th. 20th. Oh. Bad timing. Well, I'll grab it now. First, let's see what we got here. Alright, grab the skin. What's going on today? Remarks. Alright, well, looks like we're doing the best today. Go ahead and use this booster. Head out to Aram.
Warp drive active.
Some sweet looking ships in here. Let's see. Are these new skins? That's Mister.
Drive active.
Yeah, so anyway, a little bit inconvenient timing on this. It is currently Tuesday, and I will be leaving for vacation early Friday morning. So not going to be able to take full advantage of this, but you know, I guess I'll get skill points out of it anyway.
Warp drive active.
Oh, you know what? I should have grabbed some implants. That would have been the smart thing for me to do. Also, while we're at it, let's. Okay, they changed this. User interface, maybe? Okay, here we go. Presets. Of these, maybe I like the Mitar the best. Go ahead and leave it.
Warp drive active.
Is all of this text bigger? Seems a little bit brighter almost. At least in some places. Okay, cool. Epic arcs are on here.
Docking permission requested.
Interesting.
Docking request accepted.
Oh, for the pirates, right. Is it just them? Where are all of the epic arcs on here? Just those two. That reminds me, I probably should do the Sisters of Eve arc again sometime soon. Do at least a little bit of mitigation to the damage I've done to my Amar reputation. We'll explore that another time. I guess while we're thinking about it, let's see. Check the career program and see if. Looks like it's still the same. Nothing added here. Right, well, we finished all those. Oh, that's right, I died. So probably lost, I think I lost the implant. Do I have? mean, since I'm normally just alpha on this character and not, and past the point where I gain skill points over time, I haven't really used implants. So, but you do tend to gain some. Okay. Eh, I don't think I want to use that one. That seems like one I'd be sad to lose. There we go. Okay, so I do have a few at least I can put in, and I definitely have some on another character that I can sell to this guy. Bump up our training speed a little bit for the 7 days. Anyway. So yeah, as I was saying, I'll be on vacation, unable to record. Probably you won't notice anything, because I've built up enough of a buffer. Let's see, I probably want more missiles. Drop another 1,000. Anyway, I think I'll have enough of a buffer uploaded that as long as nothing goes wrong and I get back home as expected, there shouldn't be any interruption. Oh yeah. A contract with a bunch of ships sent to me. Go ahead and accept that. So we'll have to do some LP conversion in the near future, but not going to worry about it right now. Right now, we're going to blow up some Triglavians. Hopefully. Assuming the game decides to give us Triglavians to blow up.
Warp drive active.
Off to a good start. So, the other thing I think I need to do, remember to actually get myself an MTU this time when I head back to Hack. Keep saying I'm gonna do it, and then I keep forgetting. Think that'll help speed up my loot collection in these rooms, right? Because then I just have to, or actually have to go all the way to the can to loot it. I have tried this before on another character, so I know it'll work, and it'll probably work even better on this. On this character, because it's a faster ship with longer range weapons. But essentially, just fly directly to the gate. When I come in, if there are any loot boxes in range. Right away, take those out. When I get to the gate, drop the MTU, go out just far enough to blow up whatever other loot boxes there are, and then head back to the MTU essentially. Cuts down on travel time quite a bit. The MTU pulls in all the loot. And then I just have to remember to scoop it up before I jump. Works pretty well. The only downside really is the time it takes to lock and switch targets with missiles and drones. Being the other character I've done this on was flying an Omen with pulse lasers, so obviously that was pretty fast. My hypothesis is that it's not fast enough to make up for how slow the Omen is. But we'll see. Doing. Guns are so weird sometimes.
Thank you.
Yeah, definitely need an MTU. It's almost like the text is glowing a little bit. I don't know if I like that. Still trying to figure out exactly what's going on with the UI changes. Thank you. That's way over there. So, just need one more Triglavian room, as long as it's not just a single battleship. That should get us our skill points. forget to reload. Angel Insurgency will start in Colossus Wind. Imperial Ship Caster Beacon in Turner. Destroyed. Cool. That's not true what it means. There we go. Alright, so Garistas are against Kaldari. ships do they have? They do have a pretty cool symbol. I'll say that. Oh yeah, worm. Some people really like worm for doing abyssals. Haven't tried it, obviously. Mamba. Shield resistances, kinetic and thermal missile damage. Cool. The Gila. Very popular. Or Gila, perhaps, if we're assuming they speak Spanish. Drone damage. Kinetic and thermal missiles. Alligator. Oh yeah, rattlesnake. Cool. Been blown up by rattlesnakes a few times. Usually by neutrals in while I'm doing faction warfare. Torpedoes. Interesting. Alright, so so I'd have to train up Galente or offline these. So what about Angel? Dramiel's a fun ship. Add one of those and another character for a while. Stupidly lost it when I first started playing again during COVID. I was just out fighting stuff, trying to get a feel for the game again. So let's see, projectile turrets. Cinnabal. Macariel. Always wanted a Macariel. Kizrael. It's pretty cool looking. All off, so it gets range. And let's see, Titans. That is really, they are really just all about gun damage. And warp speed, I guess. So I thought. I thought the pirate factions would be going up against two two empires each, but not seeing that info. Okay, so looks like most likely Garistas will be fighting against Kaldari and Amar. Which makes sense, since until recently those two sides were pretty closely aligned. Recent metagame stuff made it more difficult to participate in each other's faction warfare stuff like it used to be. Minmatar and Galente also could work together to some degree. I never tried running any Galente faction warfare stuff, so I don't really know what the reward structure looked like for that. A little luck, we can keep enough range away from this skybreaker that this weapon won't arc back to my drones while they're fighting him. That would sure be nice. Anyway, if I'm gonna do pirate faction stuff, it'll probably be with Garistas. Doesn't look like any of the lore notes and stuff have been updated yet. We are over an hour. I'm going to go ahead and end this one here. We'll pick up with a part two tomorrow. So until next time, have a good one.